Hey guys, good afternoon. So I am going to give a minute for some other people to get on and share this on over with those of you who are in my group. Because sometimes you get group notifications a little bit better than the page notifications. Go ahead and share that over really quick. Okay. So that is on live right now. There we go. So after working with many customers and building a custom food storage plan, there are five things that they tend to forget. Now, they might not be things you need to buy first off the bat when you start doing food storage, but overall, you definitely want them in your food storage and emergency preparedness. Hey, I'm Charisse Merrill with the Merrill Project, and I'm going to tell you five things you want to double check are on your food storage list to make sure you have these. First off, comment below, and I want you to tell me what your target food storage goal is. So to store enough food for 1 month, 3 months, a year, let me know below so I know kind of what goals you guys are reaching for. When I first started building a food storage, I focused on only finding food that I could cook with a Dutch oven or over a fire. And this took up a ton of time. Like, I was stressed with finding recipes that I liked to be able to cook with in an emergency, and they ended up being recipes when I built the food storage plan that I never used, which I didn't really use my food storage, and it didn't get rotated and all of that stuff. So I just got lost. So the first thing before we even go over these five things is I'm going to tell you not to worry about how to cook with your food storage when you're planning your food storage just yet. You will later, but don't worry about it when you're first starting off. So the very first thing most people don't have in their food storage is having a way to cook. Wait, what? I just told you to not worry about what to cook with your food storage. Yes, I did. And I am the queen of confusing. You can ask my husband about that. But I took this therapy class once, and he always said there's an exception to every rule. So this is the exception to the rule of not having a way to cook. After you have planned and picked your food storage meals, you know what you'll be cooking and how you'll be cooking most of your meals, then you can think about and worry about how you're gonna cook with it outside of an emergency. So look at the meals you have planned and then decide, is it a lot of stovetop meals, crockpot meals, oven meals, and plan, and then you can be like, oh, now I know what I need to buy or invest in, hey guys, for while I'm cooking my food storage in an emergency. But again, don't focus on buying. If you're gonna buy a Sun oven because you use an oven and you live in Arizona, that's a lot of money. So don't worry about investing in that type of stuff until you have a good 3 to 6 month supply going. Okay, the second thing you may be forgetting in your food storage is comfort foods. Now, I did a video about this last month, so you may remember about the importance of comfort foods. So I'll just do it really quick and you can find the video back on if you have more questions. But the biggest takeaways are, one, comfort foods raise your moral. When you're feeling down, what do? At least girls, most of us, we like to go eat. Comfort foods give you happy hormones, you feel good when times are bad, and if you're using your food storage, you're most likely having a bad time. So that's the one reason you want comfort foods. The other reason is bribery. Bribe your kids to eat their meals, bribe your husband to eat food storage, bribe yourself. I know, bribe them to get their chores done, hey, we can bake a cake, that type of thing. So don't forget comfort foods in your food storage and make sure you have a plan for them. The third thing is spices. Now, if you've built your food storage plan off of recipes, then you don't really need to worry about spices because in that plan would have already included all the spices you need for cooking those recipes. But in case you didn't build your food storage from a recipe-based plan, then you may have forgotten to add spices. I was talking to a lady the other day and she had tons of ingredients but realized she had no spices for anything, like not nearly enough salt or seasonings for what she wanted to cook with it. And a quick side note, if you have questions about recipe-based food storage plans, you can learn all about it in my free webinar. I'm gonna link up to the registration down in the notes after the video. And it's called The Proven System to Enjoy Your Food Storage. And that will be starting in February. It's a new webinar that I'm doing. I'm excited. So I'll post it below, but the third thing, spices. Make sure you have spices. The fourth thing you may be forgetting is fruits, vegetables, meats, protein, that type of thing. So again, if you have a built your food storage from a recipe-based food storage plan, you should have all the fruits, veggies, and meats that you need in your food storage because they're coming from those recipes and that's how you built it. But a lot of people build their plan from a week-to-week basis or buy all these grains and all these oils. And if you do that type of plan or buying extra cans here or there, you're most likely forgetting some of the fruits, vegetables, and proteins that you need and eat regularly, but don't really realize it. You don't want to just be storing the grains and stuff, or you're going to be getting that food fatigue. And the last one is water. I've said it before, you've heard it a lot of times. I'm going to do it again. Do you really have enough water in your food storage? A person can only go 3 days without water, but up to 7 days without food. So I definitely recommend having at least a 3 day of physical water in your house. Now, to have more than that, it can take up a lot of space. So if you don't have space, find ways to store water without the space. So it can be there's a water bob that you can put in your bathtub and fill it up if an emergency is coming, or what we like to do is water filters. We have a ton of water filters because we get a lot of rain here in Nebraska. So make sure you have water in your food storage. So to recap, the top five things most people forget in their food storage are a way to cook, and don't worry about that until you have a few months' supply stored, comfort foods, spices, fruits, veggies, meats, and water. So if you're watching this video, you probably are only missing one or two because you kind of get my system of food storage. But just in case, let me know in the comments what you're forgetting and what you're going to work on to add to your food storage, and also if you have any questions about it. Okay, besties, if you like this video, subscribe. Join my Facebook group and ask all the questions you want. Be sure to leave a comment so I know you like these videos and I can keep making more of them. And also, if you have some questions about a recipe-based food storage plan, because it's kind of new, not really many people build food storage this way, I will insert my registration link down at the bottom of my page. So, not page, in the comment section. Sorry, guys. So, and in the other notes, I'll link up to a few other things as well. So bye for now, and I will see you guys later.